Hi, are you a doctor that can speak English, but you need to improve your medical terminology? I think you're going to like today's video because you're going to be practicing your English in the context of asthma. So in today's lesson, you're going to be learning some keywords associated with asthma, and then there will be a conversation between a doctor and a patient in which they use these keywords. Hello, my name is Dr. HS. I have a PhD in medicine. I'm an Australian scientist. I'm a certified translator, and I have this YouTube channel to help you, to help healthcare professionals improve their fluency, their confidence, and their vocabulary in medical English. If that idea sounds interesting to you, subscribe to my channel so I can make more content for you. The keywords of today are asthma.
I have asthma. I have asthma.
Oh yeah? Spell asthma. Oh yeah? Spell asthma.
Did you tell her about your lucky asthma inhaler? Did you tell her about your lucky asthma inhaler?
The cold air will trigger Leonard's asthma. The cold air will trigger Leonard's asthma.
Breathing.
Focus on your breathing. Slowly. Focus on your breathing. Slowly.
That's your big secret? Breathing? That's your big secret? Breathing?
Just breathe. Are you breathing?
Slowly in.
Just breathe. Are you breathing?
Slowly in.
Dave, do your breathing exercise. Dave, do your breathing exercise.
Listen to your breathing. Feel your heartbeat.
Symptoms.
Could you Google symptoms of labor?
He's not showing any symptoms.
You would explain your symptoms.
What were the symptoms?
What symptoms?
Sneezing.
Medication.
Are you taking medication?
Now take your medication.
Blood pressure medication. Cholesterol medication.
Mrs. Levine won't take your medication.
I'm so glad the medication worked on your foot.
The medication. I can't stop smiling.
Oh, honey, is your medication wearing off?
Narrow.
My aortic valve is 16% too narrow.
Oh, well, that was a narrow escape.
That doesn't narrow it down.
That should narrow it down.
I need to cross the narrow sea.
Life-threatening.
You had a life-threatening disease, a life-threatening doctor.
These men have life-threatening health problems.
You don't have a life-threatening condition. Why?
No insurance and no life-threatening condition.
Granted, not a life-threatening procedure, but...
Hi, Mrs. Smith. I'm Samantha. I'm a respiratory doctor. How are you? I'm okay. I have reviewed your medical results and looked at your referral letter. Thanks for coming to see me today. Can you tell me what brought you in? I have been having trouble breathing. I cough a lot and I feel really tired in the morning. My usual doctor asked me to see you. Okay. So when do you typically have these symptoms? Well, I usually cough at night, but I have trouble breathing all the time. Do you smoke? No. Does anything trigger your symptoms? Sorry, I don't know what you mean. Okay, so have you noticed if anything makes your symptoms get worse, like pollen or anything around the house? Oh yeah, now that you mention it, it always gets worse when I have a cold. Do you have a family history of asthma? Oh yeah, my brother, my sister, and my mum have asthma. Okay, I'm going to listen to your lungs and check your breathing. I hear a lot of wheezing. Have you noticed this before? Oh yeah, I forgot to mention it. I get a lot of wheezing at night. So do you know what I have, doctor? Based on what you have described to me today, as well as the results from your medical exams, I believe you have asthma. Oh, wow. What does that mean for me? Asthma is a condition in which your airways narrow and swell and may produce extra mucus. And this can make breathing quite difficult and trigger coughing and wheezing. For some people, asthma is minor, while for others, it can be a major problem that interferes with daily activities and may lead to a life-threatening asthma attack. Oh wow, so what happens now? Okay, we're going to work together to track your signs and symptoms and adjust your treatment as needed to keep it under control. I'm going to write you an asthma action plan for you to follow, and so you know what to do when your signs and symptoms get worse. You're going to go on a preventer, which is an inhaled medication. You will take it once in the morning and once at night, and you will use your reliever when you have an asthma attack. Now I'm going to ask the nurse to teach you how to use these inhaled medications properly. Does that sound okay? Yeah, it's very similar to what my mum uses, so I'm quite familiar with it. Okay, so treating asthma early may prevent long-term lung damage and help keep the condition from getting worse over time. Contact me straight away if your medication doesn't seem to ease your symptoms or if you need to use your quick relief inhaler more often. And don't take more medication than prescribed without consulting me first, okay? Overusing asthma medication can cause side effects. Okay, so should I book another appointment? Yes, please. I would like to see you in 4 weeks to see how your asthma is progressing. And don't forget to see the nurse on your way out so she can teach you the proper use of this inhaled medication. Okay, doctor, thank you. How did you find the lesson? What would you like to learn next? And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. And if you want to improve your fluency even more, don't forget to watch the other videos that I have on my channel. See you soon.